What's going on, everybody? This is the Blockchain Backer, bringing you the latest cryptocurrency news and analysis. And wow, what a start to a week. We have had a crazy weekend over here on Twitter and in the crypto market, with Bitcoin plunging in price, taking the rest of the altcoin market with it. Crazy enough as it is, if you look at that over there on the right side of the screen, there is a sea of red over there, except for one coin, which is XRP, which is in an upward move. Okay, so we'll get to that. But I think we really need to kind of paint a picture of where we're at within the whole market right now. There's a lot of chaos that happened over the weekend. Was that just a distraction from price? Was that a narrative to go along with everything? We'll take a look at all of it and see what we can draw draw out of the information that's being presented to us here on the charts. Right now, there's extreme fear in this market. That's to be expected after prices have moved to the downside. But of course, there's that narrative. There's that story with Elon Musk, Tesla, Bitcoin, decentralization, climate, all this stuff casting this big cloud, this big dark cloud over Bitcoin right now, which is also happening while prices are at the downside. So is this the end of the world for Bitcoin? Let's see if we can figure that out on this channel, because there's specific things I'm looking for to tell me that, well, it's not the end of the world. And really, even though we don't have the information on the chart just yet, if I had to make my best guess would be that no, this is not the end. Now, I'll be straight with you on that, right? So when somebody's a YouTuber and they come on here and they say that, especially when they have a YouTube channel focused on cryptocurrency, the reality is the bubble popping, everything going to the downside for a prolonged period of time is not in the best benefit of the YouTuber, right? They want the prices to keep going up. They want the excitement to happen. They want their audience to continue growing. So always take into account that there's a biasness that a YouTuber is going to have for prices to continue going up higher. Now, one of the things I've always told you guys on my channel is that whenever it's time for me to exit, whenever it's time for me to sell, when I think it's going to be over, I know that that's going to be bad for my YouTube channel. I know that's going to drastically impact my viewership. I know that that's going to drastically increase the amount of people attacking me, mad at me, telling me I don't know what I'm doing. I know that that's going to happen, and I'm willing to accept that. And so I try to come at this from a non-biased approach of just being hopium, being hype, being wanting the prices to go up for my own personal gain. Whenever I think this thing is over, I will say, I think this thing is over and I'm not going to do it. And I hope that I'm not going to do it. I hope I can time it better than that, of when this thing is just crashing into the ground and then finally saying, oh yeah, I guess that was it. I'm hoping I can do it while prices are still very high, which of course will be met with a lot of criticism. But that's okay. I would rather it be that way. I would rather it be that the prices are at the moon and I'm screaming I'm getting off the spaceship than for the prices to be crumbling to the ground and just be in that whole mess. But I'm going to show you the things that I'm looking for over here on the Bitcoin price chart to say that Bitcoin can continue moving up higher. For a lot of people that have been drawn into this market over the last 3 to 4 months, this is their first big correction. They have learned this way of life of that prices only go up. And that if you think prices are going to go down, you're a FUD starter, you're a bad person, you're a bad human. But the reality is, this is what markets do. They go up and they go down. And what we look for when they go down is, what kind of structure are they making? Are we making a crashing structure, or are we making a corrective structure? And then when we have our recovery, does our recovery show strength, or does it show that we're just retracing and we're going to continue going down even lower? The thing that had me so uncomfortable with Bitcoin over here was that we were not showing signs of strength and we were getting rejected by the 702 Fibonacci retracement. That made me uncomfortable. I saw no signs of strength coming out of Bitcoin at that time. But now we're going to get our chance to do it all over again. And the thing is, you have to think about is, right now there's a lot of extreme fear in this market, right? They say, hey, the prices are going down. They're just going to keep going down in a straight line. It's all over, man. But the reality is, markets move in waves. They go up and they go down and they go up and they go down and they go up and they go down. And the reality is, we were waiting for that moment right there if we're going to keep going down, right? So the big question is, are we going to continue trending in that direction, or are we going to see a reversal where we start marching our way up higher? The big thing we're all looking for right now is at least a reversal out of this move that we're having right now. Do we see sentiment that shows that that could happen? I completely believe so. There's been a ton of fear in this market over Elon Musk, right? People are panicked. Retail investors, like, just do anything that he tells them to do. And then over the weekend, at Peter McCormick over here on Twitter wrote out about a 20-post thread over here to explain Bitcoin and that Elon is having a hard time understanding Bitcoin, in which he replies, Bitcoin is actually highly centralized, with supermajority controlled by a handful of big mining companies. A single coal mine in China flooded, almost killing miners, and Bitcoin hash rate dropped 35%. Does that sound decentralized to you? And hey, cryptocurrency experts, ever heard of PayPal? It's possible, maybe, that I know more than you realize about how money works. So we have this move down here in Bitcoin, and not only do we have Elon Musk telling all these retail investors that Bitcoin is bad for the environment, and it burns a lot of coal, and it's excessive, but now he's even making an argument that Bitcoin is not decentralized. Whoa, wait a minute. That's a big attack on Bitcoin. That's something completely different, right? That is not just this whole Tesla protecting the environment. It's bad for their image. It's, you know, they can't accept Bitcoin because Bitcoin, you know, burns a lot of fossil fuels, right? You know, that makes sense, right? But then for Elon to actually attack the decentralized narrative, wait a minute, this is way more than just about climate. This is a full-blown attack and shots fired at Bitcoin. That one, it's really bad for the environment, and two, it's centralized to China. And when you have these two things happen, you could see that Elon's mind is pretty much made up, that Bitcoin's not the answer and that there's problems there. Or at least that's what we're to believe, or retail investors are to believe. So why is that a big deal, right? Well, we spent 3 months really building this narrative of why it's such a big deal that institutions are coming. Elon Musk is involved in Bitcoin. And then here we are 3 months later and the prices are lower. The prices never broke out. And now we're at the bottom and Elon is bashing Bitcoin. He's not just saying it's bad for the environment. He's also saying it's centralized to China and not a decentralized currency. That alone is enough to scare retail investors, but mix in all of that negative price action at the same time, it just puts extreme fear in. And the people who thought they were invested in something now feel they're not, right? They got into it because they thought Bitcoin was the future and Elon Musk was involved in it. Now they're realizing Elon Musk doesn't like it and the price is down. The excitement and hype around Bitcoin is not there right now. But these are the things that we always see in different types of price movements. When prices are to the upside, you get the positive narratives, the excitement, the hype, the fun, the laser eyes. Prices get to the bottom, you get the fear, you get the negative narratives, the negative stories. Because retail investors are designed to do the exact opposite. You are a liquidity pool for institutional investors. Your job is to buy it off of them at the tops and to sell it to them at the bottoms. And all of the news that you read and all the stories that you hear are all designed to motivate you to perform a specific action where you're supposed to do it. We all know buy low, sell high. But for some reason, people always buy high and sell low. And that's because they go with fundamental narratives, fundamental stories. What does my fundamental analysis tell me based on the news that I'm reading? But the reality is the prices would have done what they've done no matter what. There's only so much Bitcoin that's going to be sold at the bottom. There's only so much Bitcoin that's going to be bought at the top. And someone wants to get it. And that someone is not supposed to be you. So we have a tendency to see timed news events occur right where they're supposed to occur within charts. And all of this Elon stuff that we're seeing, it all does seem too well timed. When you see the potential of an ABC correction happening in here after you have a 702 Fibonacci retracement occur right in here, and then we have waves of equal length for a zigzag correction, you say to yourself, why did we get the most fear-driven narrative occur right down here at the end of wave C, right at the bottom, right as it's backtesting this previous high? So, of course, there was even more to this story. Mr. Whale, at Crypto Whale over there on Twitter, posted Bitcoiners are going to slap themselves next quarter when they find out Tesla dumped the rest of their Bitcoin holdings. With the amount of hate Elon Musk is getting, I wouldn't blame him. To which Elon Musk replied, indeed. So, boom. Now, wait a minute. Tesla's even going to be selling their Bitcoin. Holy cow. This just couldn't get any worse at this point, right? Fear, fear, fear. Panic, right? Tesla's not going to be accepting Bitcoin anymore due to Bitcoin being terrible for the environment.
Elon Musk also thinks that Bitcoin is highly centralized to China and not decentralized, and that if you think he doesn't know what he's doing, well, you must not remember that he's one of the founders of PayPal. And then, whoa, indeed, Tesla selling Bitcoin? Holy cow. So today, we get a bounce off of this previous high that happened back here. 3 hours after the bounce happens, in the middle of the night, Elon posts, to clarify speculation, Tesla has not sold any Bitcoin. That's positive news, right? Boom, that's a positive news right out of Elon. But we got negative news all the way through here, right? So when we look back through history, and we look back through anything, especially XRP holders are going to understand this the best, is that when negative news is at its absolute worst, was that the time to buy? Remember when the SEC stuff happened? Remember when Coinbase delisted XRP, price plunged down to, you know, 15, 17 cents, whatever it was. And we were in the midst of the absolute worst news out there. Was that the best time to buy? The answer is hands down, yes, it was the best time to buy. I'm not saying this is the best time to buy Bitcoin. I don't know the answer to that because we haven't had the chart continue to play out. But we do know that negative news comes with negative price action. And we know that all of this negative news happened after an A wave down with a B wave retrace back to the 702 Fibonacci retracement. Unable to crack through it. Once it was clear it was unable to crack through it, grinding higher and higher and fighting against it, it broke trend. After it broke trend, it confirmed the downtrend. That's when all this Elon Musk stuff started happening. So I think in a couple of weeks from right now, when we look back on this moment, we'll all be able to kind of say, so how did we all get played? How did they play us with the narrative this time? But the big question right now, of course, is, you know, we haven't bounced out of here yet. Are we going to bounce out of here? And what would we be looking for to bounce out of here? And I'll show you the things that I'm looking for. Let me talk about markets don't just move in straight lines, right? If we turn, we start trending, right? So the big question is going to be, what is this thing going to look like right over here? And a lot of that for me is going to depend on what is this? Is this just a back test of the top of this wave right in here? And what are we going to look like as we pull out of here from an Elliott wave perspective? And a lot of that story really gets told by this high that's been placed right in here. Now, once this thing does start bouncing out of here, the big question is going to be is, can we take out this high that's back over here and set a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? If we set a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and we do take out the top that took place over here back there at 59,500, that's very optimistic that there still is at least one more wave that's going to take us up a little bit higher. However, like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, right, YouTubers have the incentive to want to wish for more, be moon boys, be hype, all that stuff, right? Even if we do start setting new all-time highs, it needs to be remembered, my personal opinion is that Bitcoin is not going to $300,000. I don't even think Bitcoin's going to make it to $100,000 before this cycle is over. That's my personal opinion. That's how I'm working my personal exit plan, and to each their own. But essentially, if we saw something like that, then I'd be looking for an ABC back down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then back down to the high, and then we go on for our final, and then that's the end of it. That's the end of the Bitcoin bull run. All of that is going to be dependent upon seeing this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 show up in here and us taking out 59,500. The great news about that is that would add a significant amount of time to this market cycle for the altcoin market. Even if the altcoins are kind of boring during this whole time and Bitcoin's kind of just stealing back some of that Bitcoin dominance during this whole time period, it's still really positive because what we've seen in all the different market cycles is even that once Bitcoin crashes and then finally does ABC itself, we have alt season really go crazy during the retracement time period. So for those who are looking for this market cycle to continue lasting even longer, that is probably the best case scenario that I can draw out. And I still think it's actually really, really realistic because we haven't seen a full 4.236 extension in this market for Bitcoin, which takes it to that $72,000 to $73,000 price point at a minimum. When we use our previous fractals from our previous structures, like in the 2013 bull run, that gets us up there to about that $83,000 price point. So it's somewhere up there in that range. And I still deem that to be likely. Not a guarantee, but for me, I think it's still likely. And a lot's going to be dependent upon how this recovery looks like right in here. I'll get that off the screen, and that's the bullish scenario for me, right? Now, what if it's not, right? What if, like we've talked about, Bitcoin's top is actually already in, and we're watching the crumbling of Bitcoin, game over? I would really just be looking for an ABC that cannot take out that level, and in particular, most likely this one that happened right here at $58,300. Looking for something more so that could retrace back up to this level, fall back down to this level, and then one more recovery right back up to there, and then that's the end of it. Presuming that this is the bottom, right? All of this is talking as if this is the bottom. If this does change, then we start over again. If it's not the bottom, then man, I just don't think there's very much more until that bottom is in. I think we're very close, if not already there. But should we show some type of recovery like this, where we are doing an ABC structure and the altcoin market is really surging during this time period? This is where the end of the cryptocurrency market could occur. So one of the positive things that we've seen happen in here is that XRP hasn't gone on its massive bull run just yet. As you guys know, we just had this, crash, retrace 702 crash. And our previous cycles during the retracement time period is when XRP had exploded. But the thing is, we didn't see all of the altcoins explode. And in particular, we didn't even see XRP go on its big bull run. So I don't believe that the altcoin season is over yet. And we have a multiple of things happening here, right? We have Bitcoin that didn't quite reach out to its 4.236 extension. We have XRP that didn't go on its bull run. Lots of altcoins that didn't go on their bull runs yet. Some that barely broke into their all-time highs, but haven't really gotten running yet, like ADA and Litecoin. So I don't believe the excitement is done in the cryptocurrency market, but it is time to start keeping an eye on things and keeping an eye on things to get ready to come to an end. Now, that could take months, right? We could be sitting here doing this over and over again for months, or it could be weeks. But one thing we do know is that in the previous cycles, if Bitcoin did something like this, and as it got back to its retracement right here, if XRP was in a full-blown bull run and going exponentially higher, we'd be getting a pretty clear signal that, hey, you know what? This thing looks like it's coming to an end. But right now, we don't have that. And right now, we have to wait for more information to come up on the charts. So while I'm optimistic that prices are going to go higher, there is no biasness about it because I'm a YouTuber. As a matter of fact, I'm watching other Bitcoin YouTube channels yesterday just to kind of get an idea of what are they saying about all of this stuff. And you can see all of these Bitcoin maximalists that are absolutely beat down right now. That's a good sign. They were bullish during the whole time period in here, spitting out all kinds of hype and craziness. As you guys know, I didn't believe any of that. I did not think that was going to happen with Bitcoin. Now, at this point, I'm more optimistic for Bitcoin than I have been for the last 3 months. And has a lot to do with the wave structure and that we've been holding this price level down in here. So we'll see how this plays out. We'll see if that price level does end up holding. But we have a zigzag correction with waves of equal length after a 702 Fibonacci retrace with an ABC correction. Mix in at the bottom of the correction, there was a very good narrative to incite incredible amounts of extreme fear into retail investors. That's the perfect formula for a bottom. And into the 2017 bull run, I was there. I've seen this stuff happen before, where we come back, touch the top, and then march our way up higher. I'm not saying we're going to go that high for Bitcoin, but I've definitely seen time periods where we have big corrections that come back down and touch the tops of previous waves. Also, in an Elliott wave structure, when you have an ABC correction, this can come down below wave 4 of the previous wave, which is precisely what we have happening in here, but also maintaining the top of the previous wave. So for right now, I don't see anything to really panic about. And I think the real panic for me will come in on whatever this retracement looks like once Bitcoin does start recovering. Will we see it be able to do one wave that comes in above here, two, three, four, five? And the big question being, is this top over here going to get cleared? If that top over there gets cleared for Bitcoin, for me, it's very optimistic that Bitcoin is still going to continue setting new all-time highs. However, my biasness, my personal biasness, is that that top comes in somewhere in the 70s and 80s, and we do not go to the 90s, 100s, or above. And that eventually, Bitcoin will crash back down to below $20,000. And I'm talking $13,000, $14,000, $15,000 at some point. Now, don't kill the messenger. It's just technical analysis. For the Bitcoin lovers, I'm trying to give you some optimism here that I think there's a good chance that additional highs will be set, but it's going to be dependent on what the recovery looks like right here. But it's very optimistic to see so much extreme fear and such a good narrative come in at the bottom. And then now, 3 hours after that bottom gets hit, 3 hours after we have the back test of the previous high, to clarify speculation, Tesla has not sold any Bitcoin. Whoop, optimism. So that's what I'm looking for right now on Bitcoin, trying to figure out when is the cycle going to come to an end. Like I always say, I think Bitcoin's price is very high. I think we're very deep into this bull run. I know a lot of new people got poured into this because the media did not draw you in until it was already very high. But I think there's still a case for it to go even higher. And a lot will depend on what this recovery looks like right here. So I know that Bitcoin is in the thick of a storm right now. But just recognize we've seen very standard technical things happen here on the charts. And once again, it's always fun to see the 702 strikes again and proves that it is a reactionary price level. But now we wait to see, are we going to hold the support level? And what is the bounce out of here going to look like? And hopefully we see a big old bounce take us above this price level within the next day or two there at 51,600. And for all the people who have been with this channel for a very long time and have been through the XRP 22.5 cent time period, if this level right here does not hold for Bitcoin right here by touching this previous high, that 22.5 cent price level, a similar thing for Bitcoin would be this area right in here. That would be Bitcoin's 22.5 cent price hold, which we saw hold for XRP. This would be the exact same thing for Bitcoin, right there between 39,000 and 41,000. So, all right, that'll wrap it up for this one. I hope that you guys are doing okay in the midst of all the chaos happening out there. I know the only thing that's green over there on that page that I have is XRP. So I know there's probably a lot of people wanting to hear about that. We talked about Bitcoin for this entire video, but I think that the big story and the big thing to focus on has been Bitcoin at this point. What's happening? Is Bitcoin going to recover? Because Bitcoin has had such a major influence on where this market is going. So we'll talk about XRP more this week and maybe even later today. We'll see. But that's the big story. And I think we all need to kind of put into context what the market is doing right now. And for right now, nothing unusual. ABC correction, waves of equal length, after retracement to 702, back testing that previous high. I think we're okay right now. We'll wait and see how it plays. But all right, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this thing up. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you'd like, you can check out my website over here. This is bcbacker.com. This is my course where I deep dive into the previous Bitcoin bull runs, the different altcoin market cycles, tying them all together to show where those alt seasons have happened within Bitcoin's bull runs. I talk about my personal exit plans. I talk about rebalancing, mathematics, percentages, all kinds of good stuff in here. I do have updates that I've put in here. I have one there on April 30th. I also had updated my Ethereum exit plan in there. And you could check all of this out over here on bcbacker.com. You could follow me over here on Twitter at bcbacker. And once again, thank you guys so much for watching. If you could, please like this video and give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you could be notified of when I create new content and when I go live. As always, this is not investment advice and I am not a financial advisor. But if you ever need a pick-me-up or a little bit of reassurance, just remember that the blockchain backers got your back. Have a good one.